Welcome back, guys. This part of the process that I'm going to show today definitely did involve a lot of post-hole digging, which I'm not going to take the time to show you a bunch of, but I just wanted to throw a quick clip in here to prove that I did dig all these holes myself. So let's get some posts in the ground.
Hi, I'm Brian.
All right, guys, here we are. Prepping the carport site. You can see I've got three posts standing here. They're just propped up. They're not in concrete yet or anything. They are in the holes. These will be the three of the four corner posts. If I did the SketchUp drawing on a video, which I probably did, you'd know that there are going to be kind of a grid of 4x4 posts to support the roof on top of this thing. So this is just the four corner posts, and I haven't shown a ton of this prep along the way because it's been kind of slow and tedious. There's a lot of me digging holes and running strings to see things. So let me walk you through kind of what I've been doing, what the logic is here. And it all has to do with really the fact that this is not a perfectly level surface on the ground, right? I mean, I did try to kind of, you know, our land slopes a little bit from, in this picture, from left to right here. This is south to north. It slopes down slightly. So I wanted to have a nice flat spot for the carport, and actually the house is gonna go next to it, and I want that to have a flat spot as well. So I did kind of build up a flat spot here as best I could. That means that I have to kind of ramp off the front here and kind of slowly kind of grade into the back. But so it flattens out in here, but it's not perfect. You know, I got it as flat as I could, but it's not perfect. So, you know, the ground undulates a little bit with rocks and little bumps and whatnot. So the problem with that is, the reason that matters is because I just can't, if I want every post to be 2 feet in the ground, I can't just, you know, dig down 2 feet from exact level of the ground where I dig the post, because maybe over here, maybe the ground is a couple inches higher or lower or something, right? So I'm trying to be very exact about how I do this, and the only way to do that is you cannot trust the ground, right? So what you do is, I don't know if you can see it from that far away, so I'll get closer. What you do is you run these string lines, right? You attach them to some kind of post or something, and you run them from spot to spot, and you put line levels on them, which there's one over there and over there right now. I only have two line levels, so I just keep moving them around basically. But the idea is, you know, I kind of run strings where the corners of the posts are supposed to be. You can see these two strings cross right here, right? So that's where a corner of a post should be. And I've done measurements to make sure that from this corner of this post to that corner of that post is the distance I want. And same thing, that direction and the diagonal as well to show that I'm square.
Are we square?
And I've got my measurements pretty good within, you know, fractions of an inch, which is pretty good. Once you've got that all set up, you can then use these strings to kind of, you know, at the front and the back say, okay, here's the height I want the ground to be. And you then run a string line and put a level on it and make sure that it stays level. And then basically what happens is that string, in this case, for example, I hope you can see it from this far away because it's just a white string, but right in here, it represents ground level. You know, so obviously, you know, the ground isn't up to that level right now, but I can bring it up to that level with dirt and or mulch or other things, right? Because I'm going to be putting mulch on this whole thing anyway. So the ground will raise up, you know, probably an inch or two inches maybe just from mulch.
We're doing.
Let's get that fourth post in there, and hopefully we can mix up some concrete today and set these four in. All right, so here we are with the first four posts in concrete. They are plumb. They all stick 8 feet out of the ground, or at least that virtual ground that we talked about from a string line close to the ground. I'll do some work after the fact to kind of level out the ground afterwards. But here's the concrete setup. We did the collars around each one, and you know, normally I would do that to kind of have extra concrete above ground level. In this case, just because of the way the holes are dug and the way that the ground sort of isn't always all the way up to what I call virtual ground level at the strings, that collar was necessary even just to bring the thing up, I think, to ground level in some cases. So it may or may not be extra concrete, but it was necessary to get enough concrete. Hopefully that makes some sense. But that's our start. Everything's nice and square. All the measurements are right. So we're 30 feet wide from outside to outside in the front and the back. And we're 24 feet deep on the left side and the right side from front of post to back of post. So that's gonna make us three, about 10 foot bays. You know, it'll be 10 feet minus, you know, kind of the width of the post. But, and they'll be 24 feet deep. And the roof will hang over about 2 feet on the front and back, and a little over, maybe around a foot and a half on the sides. So we're started. So what I'm doing now, you might not be able to see it from here, but I have a string line from this front post to this front post, and I just measured where I need to dig my next set of holes. So there are gonna be, you know, in each of these rows, let's say, there's gonna be four posts to create my three bays. So I'm doing the front two posts, then I'll do the back two posts, then I'll do the side posts, and then to do the interior posts, I'll run strings across all of those to basically make a grid. So just gonna be a lot of post hole digging, manual, and some concrete filling. So that's what we've got in front of us for a little while. Let's get to it. All right, y'all, this is taking a little while, but here we are. I've got 12 posts around the outside, all concreted in. Measurements all good, height's all good. Now, I'm actually gonna cut down from this front row. This front row will stay the height it is, but every other row will be cut down. So I still have to do that, but I was down to the four inner posts. So tonight I've dug the holes and set those posts in place and braced them so that tomorrow, as you can see, the sun's going down. Tomorrow morning, we will come out and concrete these first thing in the morning, like all the others. But I mean, we're looking pretty solid here. If you're working with wood, just a little tip, wood tends to twist the longer you let it sit, right? When it's delivered or you get it from your Home Depot or your Lowe's or whatever, you know, it's usually pretty straight. And especially if you pick it out, you might pick out the straightest ones you can. But the second you get those home, I mean, those things are drying and they're turning and twisting and bending and all those things. So I've had these for a few weeks now, and some of them have been twisting pretty good. So I'll try and give you an example. This one at the bottom, you can see kind of, this is if I'm pointed straight kind of towards the other posts, it's all kind of kicked, right? And that's because this post twisted a bunch. So even though it's off kilter down here at the bottom at the ground, by the time it gets up here, it has twisted and it's facing the direction I want it to face. So as I put these in place and as I cement these tomorrow, obviously I want to be level. Again, I think I may have talked about this before, but there's a lot of things to think about when you cement these things in. The distance they are from everything else, that they're in the right position, that they're centered in the hole, that they're plumb, you know, this way and this way, that they're plumb. But there's also now this additional dimension of, I want the tops of them to face in the right direction. So I don't care if this is all twisted down here. What I care is that this top part faces in the line that I want. So that was just another thing to think about, or it is another thing to think about as I cement these in. So you'll see that the bottom isn't really facing in the right direction. It's kind of all twisted, but it's the top that matters. So that's what's important to me. So anyway, with this, I am ready, hopefully first thing in the morning, to cement these last four in and then remove those braces. And I've got my 16 posts and I've got my three bays to drive in. 1, 2, 3. And the next step then is to cut these down to height so that I can then put beams across. Boom, boom, boom. So I'll do beams across those after I cut them down, 4x6 beams. And then those will be the basis for my rafters that will run this way. 2x6s standing up, rafters using standard rafter ties to create my roof that I'll put some purlins on top of and a metal roof. So we're getting there. It's moving a little slow, but that's fine. I'm not a production builder or anything. I don't have to build 20 of these things. I just have to build one. So I don't really care how long it takes as long as I get it right. So
we'll come back tomorrow after we've cemented these in and we'll talk again.
Okay, so it's time to chop these post tops off. I have to do this 12 times, but this is one example. What I'm trying to do here, because I'm using a circular saw, and a circular saw can only cut so deep. So because that thing's 3.5 inches wide this way, I have to cut it twice. I have to cut it once and then come around the other side and cut it again to cut it off. So the problem with doing that, anybody who's tried to ever do that before, is it's hard to get a nice level cut without those two cuts being off slightly. So what I'm using is I'm measuring for the distance that the blade is away from the edge of the saw plate, the base plate on the circular saw. And I'm putting a straight edge and clamp it in place so I can just kind of run along that. And then I'll move it around the other side and do the same thing. Hopefully it'll come out nice. All right, so I don't know if you can tell from this angle, but all the posts are cut down. So these are about 8 feet tall. These drop about 4 inches, 4 more inches, 4 more inches. So these are about 7 feet tall. That'll be both sides. I'd like to be able to drive through either way, the carport. So the lowest side will be 7 feet, and that should be plenty of height for the truck. So we're done with that portion. I just need to do a quick little housekeeping on top of each of these posts because I cut them all off and they're all treated. I'm gonna use some treatment that I have in a jug to just paint on the tops of those. I'll do that real quick, and then we'll get started on putting the beams on top. We're going to prep the beams by shosugi bonding, so burning and brushing and sealing. So we'll do that with all the beams that are going to go across, but that's our next step, is to put the beams across. Alrighty, check back in a bit. Okay guys, one of a few moments of truth here. I've got my beams just set. They're just resting up there, so they're not connected yet, but let's take a close up and see what's going to happen here. This is going to work. Oh, I just lost my gloves. So I'll be setting up the compressor here in a minute, so I won't have any sound, but here's the idea. So these guys will be squeezed up tight on top of this post right here. That's the end post there. That's going to hang out over the edge. They'll meet over this post. They'll meet over that post, and it'll hang out over the far edge over there. So at every one of these connection points, where two of them meet up and where it's just crossing, that's just one piece, it's not meeting. But every one of these connection points will have these post caps. There are many different types of post caps. This one happens to be something that can go on top of a 6x. So this is 4x6. So this is 6 or 5.5 really, but for 6x material. So it's gonna sit on top of this post and it's gonna connect to both of these beams to hold them in place. So that's gonna happen on both sides of the post. There'll be one on the back side, one on the front side. So that'll be here where they meet, there where they meet, down there at the end, and down there too. So that's what I'm about to attach. I'm gonna use a palm nailer. Thanks to Craig and Nikki for letting me borrow it. It is a device that runs with an air compressor. It's an air device, pneumatic, I think you would call that. And that's just, I mean, I could hammer these in. I'm gonna use 3-inch screws here. Or sorry, 3-inch nails. Those nails being 3 inches long, they could bend with a hammer. And as far as a nail gun, which I have a nail gun isn't for like precise stuff like this. If I used a nail gun, I wouldn't be able to hit this little hole right here. But with a palm nailer, I can kind of load a nail into that thing and put it up against in this hole. And then it'll kind of da-da-da-da-da, you'll see what I'm gonna do here. So anyway, that's what I'm about to do. Let's give it a go. Okay, so far, it does want to jump around though, so you gotta hang on to whatever you're nailing in. Well, there's one row of four. Three more just like that. All right, here we are with all the beams done now. You can see your four rows of posts and beams. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the front, that's the high end. This is the back end, it's lower, it's a foot lower. So there are the bays, 1, 2, 3. So taking us a while to get here. You can see a little bit of mulch around the bottom too. I've spread around the outside. The whole inside will be covered with mulch too. I'm just using what I've got to kind of, I wanted to hit the slopes first. It's a little sloped on coming in this way and a little sloped coming out this way. So this is pretty flat. So I wanted to hit the sloped areas first in case we do get any rain to keep that water from running. So that's where we're at. So next is gonna be the rafters running this way. They're actually, because of the length, they'll each be made up of three boards that will meet on top of these beams along the way. It's gonna be fun. A lot of work still to go, but it's starting to look like something. I could actually drive into those right now if I want to. And I did drive the truck in once, I think, when the posts were up. So just to make sure that I was fitting all right and everything's good. We should be all right. So next up is the rafters. See you next time.